When my son was maybe 10, 11 years old, like any young boy, he was ready to conquer the world, right? And he had been asking me for months, "Dad, can I drive the car? Can I drive the car?" Well, my father-in-law, his grandfather, had already let him drive the truck, but down at their farm, which is just acreage and land and what have you. And he was just convinced, man, if he can do it there, he can do it anywhere. So one day he was with me and I was headed to my office. At the time I officed at a nice airport park in a facility, and just lots of concrete and hangars and different things like that. And we went in the gate. He says, "Dad, I want to drive." And there was no one else there that day. And so I switched with him and I said, "Okay, so you're going to drive about 300 yards down here to the fifth building. And then when we get there, we're going to stop and then I'll switch with you and I'll park the car." So he gets in, he's doing great. He's looking up over the visor there or the windshield, and he's driving very slowly and he's just doing fine. And he comes to basically where I was going to have him stop, and he stopped there and he says, "Dad, I can do it. I can turn." I said, "Okay, so turn left and we'll start moving toward the parking spot here." So he turns left 90 degrees and he starts moving toward that way. And there was one more 90 degree turn that he needed to take in order to park in the parking spot. I said, "Son, I don't really feel comfortable you doing that." "Dad, I got this. I got this." You know where I'm going with this, right? So I said, "Okay, son, keep your foot on the brake. You don't need the accelerator for anything. Keep your foot on the brake and you're gonna just ease yourself into that parking spot." So he turns, lines up. He's coming up on the curb there, or not, there was no curb actually. It's just a concrete deal up to the wall. And as he was just about to stop, his foot came off of the brake, went fully on the accelerator. He didn't park my car in the parking spot. He parked my car in my office. That cost me some money. It was a lesson learned. Here's the deal. I love my son. I trust him. I mean, he's a great kid. He's at that time, even at that age, his heart was right. His attitude was right. He was well behaved. He was mannerly and all. He had so many great qualities. And there was no lack of love in my heart for him. But the truth was, from a maturity place, from a preparation place, from a place of being ready, he was not ready, mature, or prepared for the level of responsibility that I chose to give him in that moment. And here's what I want to share with you today. When the student is ready, the teacher appears. Some of you are like complaining and fussing and worried about the fact that your opportunity hasn't come to you yet or hasn't shown up yet. Some of you who are people of faith, you're fussing about God. Why is God withholding from me? Why is He keeping good things from me? Why is He whatever? I want to share with you very simply. The principle is pretty clear. When you're ready, the stuff you're waiting for shows up. Your dreams, your aspirations, your success, your prosperity, the money you're waiting, all the things that you believe you have in your future that you're capable of attaining and doing and succeeding in, they're there. And no one's withholding them from you per se. It's just that the student's not ready yet. And so the onus is upon you and I to make ourselves ready. What areas do I need to grow in? What knowledge do I need to obtain? What course do I need to enroll in? What college do I need to go back to? I mean, what relationships do I need in my life? What things do I need to fix that are really broken in my life? Because sometimes dad is not withholding from us because he doesn't love us. He's really protecting us from ourselves because we're not ready to handle it yet. I'm reminded of the movie where Jack Nicholson, "You can't handle the truth." Well, sometimes, ladies and gentlemen, we're simply not ready to handle the greatness, the goodness, the big things that God has made ready for us. He's just waiting on us to kind of grow up a little bit, deal with our attitudes, deal with our limiting beliefs, deal with our issues that are unresolved, so that when He does really unload on us, not only can we handle it, but we can run with it and we can do well. When the student's ready, teacher appears. What is it in your life that you need to be ready for? And what do you need to do to make ready for it? My name's Brian Holmes. Great to have you with us today. And I encourage you, go after it hard. Make yourself ready because great things are coming your way.
We'll be right back.